Good evening. Welcome to Grandma's Attic Music Review. I love my job. When I do this, this is one of the thrilling joys of my life to be able to bring you guys live music, especially those of you that don't go out to live shows. It's really, really a thrill to be able to bring to you music that you normally wouldn't get to see unless you went out to live shows. Now, every once in a while, I get to bring people back. And you know that I do that. You know that reruns are a thing. Tonight's not a rerun. It's a redo. We've had this young man here. I believe this is his third time. It might even be three times. He's been here three times. This third time. Now he's all grown up. Yeah, you're right. He was a youngster when he came the first time, and now he's grown and he's doing all kinds of wonderful things. We're going to talk to him in a few minutes, but first, let me introduce to you again, please welcome into your homes, Frankie Justin.
Oh, thank you guys. I hope you guys like it. We're going to start it off with some Jordan Davis, Singles You Up. I heard you laugh like that in a long time. Wonder if you stopped his world like it did mine just now. See you sipping white wine instead of whiskey. Does he want you to be just a little more city? Well, I'm sorry if I'm overstepping boundaries I don't mean to be. I just gotta tell you how I feel. He ever singles you up, he's ever still bad enough. I'ma be the first one calling him crazy. If he ain't holding you tight, if he ain't treating you right, I'ma be the first one calling him crazy. Cause girl, just a matter of time until you find that the right guy staring you back until you rise right now. No rush, but if he ever singles you up, he ever singles you up, I'ma be the first to call, baby. Hasn't even looked your way since you walked in. I can't help it that I can't take my eyes off of you. Favorite song just came on and you and me are singing along, and he don't know a single word. If he ever singles you up, if he's ever still bad enough, I'ma be the first one calling him crazy. If he ain't holding you tight, if he ain't treating you right, I'ma be the first one calling you baby. This girl, just a matter of time until you find that the right guy staring you back until you rise right now. No rush, if he ever singles you up, if he ever singles you up, I'ma be the first to call, baby. Sorry if I'm overstepping boundaries I don't mean to be. I just gotta tell you how I feel. If he ever singles you up, if he's ever stupid enough, I'ma be the first one calling him crazy. If he ain't holding you tight, if he ain't treating you right, I'ma be the first one calling you baby. Cause girl, just a matter of time until you find that the right guy staring you back until you rise right now. No rush, if he ever singles you up, if he ever singles you up, I'ma be the first to call, baby. Thank you guys so much.
Woohoo!
Well, I'm going to tune up my guitar here. It has been a crazy year. We'll talk about that a little bit more later. But while I'm tuning up, I might as well say something. But yeah, we had over 60 shows this year. I've been everywhere from the east to the west to everywhere. So it's been really cool. Songs on the radio, and it's just been my best year yet. We've been having a lot of fun. We're all tuned up. Gonna be doing some Chris Young here. Chris Young is one of my favorite country singers. And I hope you guys like this next song. It was a big hit of his last year. It's called Hanging On. I'm a few drinks in, but that ain't the reason I'm all tongue-tied and my breath's leaving this fast. I can't get past those blue eyes shining, they keep drawing me into you. Got me falling off track. You get me like that, yeah. Yeah, I'm hanging on to every word you say, every move you make. Hanging on, wondering what's up next, girl, I can't wait. Ain't nothing like spinning you around the room where everyone can see you hanging on to me. No, it ain't the song and it ain't the playlist. It's every smile coming off of your sweet lips. It makes me want to stay here. No, this ain't a one-night, one-time thing. You always light me up like a flame and it's clear every time you're near. Yeah, I'm hanging on to every word you say, every move you make. Hanging on, wondering what's up next, girl, I can't wait. Ain't nothing like spinning you around the room where everyone can see you hanging on to me. You hanging on to me. So let me pull you a little closer. Even when the music's over. Yeah, I'm hanging on to every word you say, every move you make. Hanging on, wondering what's up next, girl, I can't wait. Ain't nothing like spinning you round the room where everyone can see you hanging on to me. You hanging on to me. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. This next song was my first single to country radio. It's called Summer Lover. It's out on iTunes and Spotify, and I hope you guys like it. I want to thank country radio for making this my very first single to radio to be played all across the country. It's called Summer Lover. It's a song I wrote on the back of, literally on the back. I'm not trying to get too country on here, but I wrote it on the tailgate of my old truck, and I couldn't believe where it went. From just writing it one day on the truck to recorded to on the radio and hearing it going down the road. So I hope you guys like it. It's called Summer Lover. Sunny day living beachside, baby. Getting ready for the bonfire. Putting on that beach attire. Red bikini she is wearing. If and I, we are blaring. Summer night feels just right. Sipping light, holding her tight. Gonna be one of those times. Wish she didn't fly home by. Gonna hit it up, live it up, give it all. Light it up, keep it up, have a ball. Ride this seaside wave until it falls. It's summer, not a bummer. There ain't nothing funner. Being a summer lover. Nothing better than her starry eyes. Matching the sky tonight. Mix up a drink of her in July. Be the hottest drink you ever did try. Boy, she is a sight. Loving up on me in this beachside breeze. Gonna hit it up, live it up, give it all. Light it up, keep it up, have a ball. ride this seaside wave until it falls. It's summer, not a bummer, there ain't nothing funner being a summer lover. Her flip-flops, high top, making my jaw drop, living a lot. Don't want it to stop. Gonna hit it up, live it up, give it all. Light it up, keep it up, have a ball. Ride this seaside wave until it falls. Gonna hit it up, live it up, give it all. Light it up, keep it up, have a ball. Ride this seaside wave until it falls. It's summer, not a bummer, there ain't nothing funner being a summer lover. Summer lover. Sunny day living beachside, baby, all night long driving me crazy. Thank you guys so much.
Woo!
It's out there. You can stream it and everything. And, you know, it's like I say, it's been a crazy year. You know, I got to meet some great people in Nashville and New York, and people from Nashville and New York. As crazy as that sounds, when you go to meetings and you meet people. Well, I've been able to cut some great songs this year by some great songwriters. As I just tune this guitar up, make sure we're sounding good out there. And, you know, it's been really cool when you can have, like, a childhood hero. Like, because as Dot says, you know, I've been on this show about 3 times. And, you know, all over those years, you know, you're just giving it your best. Doing a bunch of shows, writing, trying to do it. And, you know, you have these guys who are songwriters who are just heroes of yours. And when they let you cut some of their songs, that's pretty special. I had that happen this year. Chris Dubois and he pitched me this song, and I was so fortunate to cut it. It's been my best single yet. It's out on Music Row, and we're 60 in the charts this week, the highest we've ever been. So I cannot thank you guys enough and country radio enough for all of that. It's also on Spotify and iTunes. This is my first single that has done amazing, and it's called Broken Heartbreak. Sitting in the middle of a crowd, getting loud, hanging out downtown with a bunch of my friends. Sipping on Patron in the zone, getting my game on when you walked in. What the hell, girl, what you think? Saturday night and you wanted a drink. Well, there's 100 other bars up and down this street. Why'd you pick the one where you knew I'd be? 'Cause you know this is where I go. So why'd you come in here looking like that when you know damn well that I want you back? You already broke my heart, so don't be coming in my bar. If you're gonna be gone, girl, give me some space. Give this broken heart a break. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I need a broken heart break. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Here you come walking up to me with a drink like it ain't no thing that you're here tonight. Hugging all my friends, how you been? Good to see you again, like it's all right. What the hell, girl, what you trying to do? Did you put on that dress and decide that you didn't hurt me as bad as you wanted to? So you're seeing what else you can put me through? 'Cause you know this is where I go. So why'd you come in here looking like that when you know damn well I want you back? You already broke my heart, so don't be coming in my bar. If you're gonna be gone, girl, give me some space. Give this broken heart a break. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I need a broken heart break. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Girl, you said me and you were through. Said you're seeing somebody new. Said you wanna be left alone if that's what you want. What do you want, girl? Cause you know this is where I go. So why'd you come in here looking like that? No damn well that I want you back. You already broke my heart. So don't be coming in my bar. If you're gonna be gone, girl, give me some space. Give this broken heart a break. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I need a broken heart break. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. We got some more songs for you here. We're going to pick it up here with one of my... Now, here's one of my favorite bands out right now is Dan and Shay. They got this song called How Not To. And, oh, it's just such a great song. And I hope you guys like it, and I hope I don't mess it up. I can honestly understand why it's over. I can go through the motions of walking away. I can give you the key and take my things back. I can find plenty of things to fill my days. But I don't know how not to think about you when it's late at night and quiet. And I know that I ought to be the one who is strong and just moves on. But I probably turn down your road, knock back on your door, fall back in your arms, wake up in the morning hating myself for the way that I can't help the way I still want you. I just don't know how not to, how not to, how not to. You like second nature, baby, you just like breathing. A melody in my head that I can't forget. Time goes by and I still need you. Yeah, you were the heartbreak and the regret. But I don't know how not to think about you when it's late at night and quiet. And I know that I ought to be the one who is strong and just moves on. But I'll probably turn down your road, knock back on your door, fall back in your arms, wake up in the morning hating myself for the way that I can't help the way I still want you. Just don't know how not to, how not to, how not to. I don't know how not to, how not to, how not to. I don't know how not to think about you when it's late at night and quiet. I know that I ought to be the one who strong and just moves on. But I probably turn down your road, knock back on your door, fall back in your arms, wake up in the morning hating myself for the way that I can't help the way I still want you. Don't know how not to, how not to, how not to. Don't know how not to, how not to, how not to. Whoa. Love that song. Thank you guys so much. Oh, man. You know, it's so cool just to see. I've always been a fan of making records, which, you know, people don't call it records anymore. But in Nashville, you know, what a lot of us say is it's still a record, the actual song and the actual song, the recording. You know, so a lot of us artists still call it a record. And that's just been a passion of mine for years. And it's really cool when you hear a song like that. And then, like I said, you meet the guy who writes it and get to know the people and stuff. And that is just one of my favorite records. When people ask me all the time, what's one of your favorite songs? And I can never tell them because I love so many, but that one's on the list. I got a song been doing some movies and TV shows as well as the music. And so I fell in love with Out West Hollywood and stuff and the idea of Marilyn Monroe and James Dean. So I decided to write a song like called Marilyn and Dean. And it's if Marilyn and Dean were like a couple, if there were two kids today and their relationship was like Marilyn and Dean, if that makes sense to you. Two kids today wanting a relationship just like Marilyn Monroe and James Dean. Never had a relationship, but it's like that whole 50s kind of relationship thing. So, if that makes sense, I hope you like this next song. This is going to be released as an exclusive Spotify single here in pretty soon here. And I hope you guys like it. It's one that I wrote. I'm a rebel without a cause till you give me one. Raising hell and always on the run. You're alluring as a warhawk at its best. Girl, you make a 7-year itch sidestep. All reputations don't matter. Identity, social status. We can be a California story, thrown back to the days of glory. We'd make a hell of a scene, like Marilyn and Dean. Your skin on the back of my Harley Classic, your Chanel number 5 left on my jacket. We can live as if we'll die today. Love our cares and your Revlon away. If we are a California story, thrown back to the days of glory, we'd make a hell of a scene like Marilyn and Dean. Young and reckless with the action, up and restless with the passion. Oh, girl, can you imagine a California story? Sun-kissed days of glory. California story, thrown back to the days of glory. We'd make a hell of a scene like Marilyn and Dean. Marilyn and Dean. Thank you. So yeah, that's a new song that's going to be coming out here on Spotify pretty soon. And I got some more songs for you if you want to hear them. This next song, I'm going to do a cover. And let's see here. This next one is a good song. It's one of my favorites. I was at country radio this year. This guy is so cool and such a great artist, Morgan Wallen. And I got to meet him earlier this year. And then when this song came out, I was like, dang, it's a good song. And everybody else thought so, too, because it was in the top 5. It's called Whiskey Glasses. Pour me another drink. Cause I don't want to feel a thing no more, hell no. I just want to sip it till the pain wears off. Pour me another round. Light them up and knock them down, 2 more, let's go. Cause I don't want to hurt like this no more. Don't want to think about her, wear her into that her. Don't want to hit the karaoke bar, can't sing without her. Make them drinks strong, cause brother, she's gone. If she ain't ever come back, I'ma need some whiskey glasses. Cause I don't wanna see the truth. She's probably banging out on the couch right now with someone new. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'm gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I'ma need a double shot of that heartbreak proof. See the world through whiskey glasses. Thank you. last call. I swear this'll be my last call. I drunk down no more at 3 a.m. Mr. Bartender hit me again. Don't wanna think about her, we're into that her. Don't wanna hit the karaoke bar, can't sing to that her. Make them drinks strong, cause brother she's gone. If she ain't ever come back, I'ma need some whiskey glasses, cause I don't wanna see the truth. She's probably making out on the couch right now with someone new. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'm gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I'ma need a double shot of that heartbreak proof. Say the world through whiskey glasses. See the world through whiskey glasses. Light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up. Knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up. If she ain't ever come back. Light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up, light 'em up. Knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back, knock 'em back. Fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up, fill 'em up. If she ain't ever coming back. I'ma need some whiskey glasses, cause I don't wanna see the truth. She's probably banging out on the couch right now with someone new. I'ma need some whiskey glasses if I'm gonna make it through. If I'ma be single, I'ma need a double shot of that heartbreak proof. See the world through whiskey glasses. See the world through whiskey glasses. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. So yeah, I got some more songs for you here. This is a song of mine. It's not a song of mine, but a song that I cover. Always have loved this song. I hope you guys like it. It's called Heartache on the Dance Floor by John Party. Yeah, I was just hanging out some little West Coast town. Found a bar out by the sand, so I made my way in. First thing that caught my eye, like nothing I ever seen. Sunburned auburn hair, a California dream. Yeah, she was shaking them hips, some old Motown song. I couldn't say a thing, so I sang along. She was a heartache on the dance floor. Yeah, she moving through my mind. I gotta know her name, I got to see her again. She's got me wondering, yeah, I'm just wondering. Where she is, where she is, where she is tonight. Where she is, where she is, where she is tonight. Whoa, 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 whoa. I just hunt around this little West Coast town. I drop by every night, I say no closing time. My little mystery, that girl is killing me. So I put on the song, just to sing it along. She was a heartache on the dance floor. Yeah, she moving through my mind. I gotta know her name, I got to see her again. She's got me wondering, I'm just wondering. Where she is, where she is, where she is tonight. Where she is, where she is, where she is tonight. She's got me mesmerized, she's all I'm thinking about. All I'm thinking about, thinking about, thinking about. So I'm right here right now, humming this little song. If I could say a thing, I'd want you to know. You were a heartache on the dance floor. Yeah, you moved through my mind. Oh, I got to know your name, I got to see you again. And if you're listening, listening, listening. listening. Where you at tonight? Where you at tonight? Girl, I'm hanging around this little town. Where you at tonight? Where you at tonight? Whoa. Thank you, guys.
Frankie, you want to do one more song and then come talk to me?
Let's do that.
That sounds good.
This song right here is a song that was, again, pitched to me by some of my favorite writers, Ben Haislip. And it's called Spotlight. It's going to be the next single out, coming up on a date, but it's going to be the next radio single. And this is my favorite song I've ever recorded, written by some of my heroes, David Lee Murphy, Ben Haislip, and Brian Simpson. And hope you like it. I'm going to do the acoustic version of Spotlight. They got the crystal ball spinning around, dance floors packed with everybody in town. I don't know your name, I don't know who you came with, sure looking good and I don't see no boyfriend. Girl, it's like you're standing in the spotlight. Ain't no way I'm gonna take my eyes off of you. Baby, I can watch you smiling all night. Dancing that way, looking red hot. Hey, little girl, you know you got the spotlight. Oh, girl, you're moving like you're out there alone. Straps on your shoulder, barely hanging on. I can't see those eyes under that cowboy hat. But girl, I got a feeling you know where mine are at. Girl, it's like you're standing in the spotlight. Ain't no way I'm gonna take my eyes off of you. Baby, I can watch you smiling all night. Dancing that way, looking red hot. Hey, little girl, you know you got the spotlight. Yeah, you got the spotlight. Sure would love to talk to you. Maybe buy you a drink or two. Bottle it up the way you shine. Got the whole place hypnotized. Girl, it's like you're standing in the spotlight. Ain't no way I'm gonna take my eyes off of you. Baby, I can watch you smiling all night. Dancing that way, looking red hot. Hey, little girl, you know you got the spotlight. Girl, you got the spotlight. Ain't no way I'm gonna take my eyes off of you. Baby, I can watch you smiling all night. Dancing that way, looking red hot. Hey, little girl, you know you got the spotlight. Yeah, you got the spotlight. You got the spotlight. Yeah, you got the spotlight. You got the spotlight. Thank you, guys.
So while Frankie's getting his guitar off and coming over here and getting mic'd up, let me just talk to you a little bit about the holiday season. Yeah, all the holidays are upon us. And, you know, my idea of keeping money in our community is really all about shopping small. Go to your local mom and pop shops. Go to the local galleries. Go to the local whatever, craft shops, the local bookstores, the local record shops. The Telegraph is down there. Yep. All those places are there, and they are our community. If you use your money in our community, it stays in our community. Cool stuff, right? Do that for me, okay? I'm going to shop local. You shop local, too. It's a good thing. I'm going to talk to Frankie now.
How are you doing?
Oh, my gosh. I'm so happy to have you back.
Oh, I'm so happy to be back. Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. I can't. When I saw your name, it came across my Facebook, and I'm like, he needs to come back on my show. I think that you had posted something about you were sitting on a truck in the picture that was posted. You were sitting on a truck. I don't remember. And so, yeah, right? And you were talking about just getting home from being abroad. So tell me about all of these wonderful travels that you've been on.
It's been insane. You know, I was 5,000 miles in October. We've been going everywhere. Nashville, of course, is where all the music is based out of now and all the business. So I'm there a lot. I'm in New York a lot. I'm in everywhere a lot. Not here much
Not
anymore.
Here a lot. Right. How does it feel to really be actually kind of making it as a country star?
Oh, man. It's just been amazing, you know. It's been one blessing after the next. And every time I turn around, it's like, wait, did that just happen? So it's, you know, I've been doing this 9 years now. And it's really cool to see everything I worked for and everything come to where I've been wanting it to go.
Right.
You know, and it's all about realistic goals, faith over fear. And it's amazing to see all that happen.
So when you first started out, you were taking lessons with Matt Bureau.
That's right. Music Bureau.
At the Music Bureau. Absolutely. He's been on now with Borderline Genius.
His
group has been on the show, and they're doing some fun things. So those are some pretty small beginnings, Frankie.
Well, you know, I wouldn't call them small beginnings. I'd call them, you know, that is where I come from. Those are my beginnings.
Right.
Everybody starts out somewhere and, you know, great people. And, you know, Matt taught me so much. And I carry it with me everywhere I go, no matter what.
Right.
And, you know, they were great beginnings. And it's something that I am more than grateful for to have had in my life.
Absolutely. Now, your parents are also great supporters of what you're doing.
Amazing.
They have really supported where you're going with your music and things. I know it feels great, but how does it feel to know that a lot of people don't have that kind of support? How does it feel to have a family that's as supportive as yours?
You know, it feels awesome. I have so much, you know, they always say, behind a great man isn't just a great man, it's a great team. It's great people. You know, I'm lucky to have a family that believed in me, and all the time. You know, they always believed in me. And that's something that is really priceless, you know?
It is priceless, absolutely.
And it just feels great to have that base, that rock, I guess you would say,
right,
always there. You know?
That's nice. So you've had music on the radio. Now you've got a song on the charts.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. You've got a song on the charts.
I've been freaking out
Big deal. And it's number 60. It's not like it's down at the bottom at like 100 or 500. It's at 60.
Yeah.
How does that feel?
Well, you know, again, it's one of those dreams. It's been a dream of mine, you know. I remember sitting here at the start of the year saying, okay, what are my realistic goals? You know, obviously you always say out some realistic goals that are very unrealistic. And that's kind of was one of them. And then once I got the news, my label called me up. I was up here, actually. It was back in the summer. I think I was doing some fairs and stuff.
Yeah.
They said, you charted. And I just freaked out. And I was like, what? This is insane. Because here's the thing. Like, we had a conversation the day before where it's funny how it works. Like, they're like, this could go either way. Right before it charted, they were like, this could either plummet back to the bottom or it can actually chart. Don't get your hopes up. 2 hours later, they gave me the phone call. And they're like, we were teasing you.
Nice.
So, you know, we've been on the charts now, I think, 13 weeks, Music Row. And to be going across, I'm getting all these messages now. It's really weird. Because, like, I'm getting these messages of people like, oh, I heard your song, man. You're going to do well. Random people I've never met in faraway states like Missouri and different places.
Yeah.
There's stations who are just starting to pick it up now that I don't even know personally, that aren't even, like, on the board of the reporters. And they'll be like, oh, I heard it on this station. And it's like, what? It's like catching on. So that's really cool.
That's
all, you know, having the right song and the right people behind it.
Well, and a little bit of faith.
A lot of that.
Absolutely.
Been a lot of prayers said. We've had a lot of answered prayers this year. So.
Absolutely. What are some of your favorite memories of the last year? Some of the people that you've met maybe or just some of your favorite memories.
I worked on Gemini Man with Will Smith.
Okay.
Meeting Will Smith and hanging out with his friends was insane. Worked 2 days on that in New York. That was a highlight. Jamming with Dierks Bentley was insane. I was backstage at the Opry hanging out with some friends. I was like, that's Dirk's dressing room, and he's in there. I'm like, there were a bunch of people hanging out, and I had another friend who was showing him some guitars in there, George Gruen. And so we're like, well, let's just go in there and hang out. And so I'm like all nervous because I'm like, it's like, I try not to get starstruck, and I always tell you.
We all do.
Yeah, I always say, like, oh, I don't get starstruck. And it depends. Like, I'd say 30 to 40% of the time I don't. I mean, I hang around guys like Dirk Bentley and Garth Brooks. I'm just, like, freaking out. And so Dirk's was really cool. He, like, handed me his guitar and was like, what do you think of this guitar, Frankie? And I'm like, what? What is happening?
Right?
Garth. I got to meet Garth.
That would have blown my mind.
Here's a cool story if you want to hear this.
Yeah, yeah.
Garth is the most humble artist I've ever met.
I imagine.
You hear that a lot, but it's so nice when you go and you see it. And so I was just like, hi, Mr. Brooks. Nice to meet you. And then, hi, Miss Yearwood. Nice to meet you. And my buddy's saying, yes, my buddy Frankie here's got a song on the charts. And then Garth goes just like this. And this was so cool. I was so nervous that night. And he goes, okay, got a song on the charts. Are you nervous? I'm like, very. And then, you know, we just started talking. We had a great conversation for a couple minutes. And talking about my dad's saddle company and everything. And he was just amazing. You know, him and Miss Yearwood were just so cool. Those are some cool moments, obviously. Hearing my song on the radio, every time I hear that, that's been something that's been insane. And just seeing it up there on the charts. I mean, I think this week we're next to, like, Low Cash, Michael Ray, and I'm in between those guys in the charts. And that's just,
how's
like,
that feel?
It feels amazing to be up again, you know, with these guys. And, you know, Low Cash have been friends for years now, a few years now. And it's just amazing to be up with these guys, you know, be on a chart that's everybody else is on.
What does your record company think about now that you're charting, and what do they think about you doing going forward?
Well, you know, they're really excited. And, you know, radio's saying, you know, it wasn't given. You know, everybody has to work for anything.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And nothing, I think you need to come in with the right songs. You need to come in with the right faith, truly, and the right work ethic. You know, and if you don't have all those three things working, to me, for me personally.
Absolutely.
You know, it just doesn't get it across. So, you know, my label and everybody's saying, you know, and radio is saying, you know, here's a guy who stuck through it the past 2 years, well, 9 years, but 2 years going, trying to accomplish this goal, and he's still coming back and doing it. Now he's done it. So that's something that is applaudable, I guess, what they're telling
me. It's very applaudable.
It's not giving up, and it's the biggest thing. You know, there's days where you're going to have, like, why did I not go to college? What did I do? But there's days where, you know, you look back at the year and you're like, well, shoot, I did 60 shows this year. Shoot, I've been on the charts 13 weeks. Shoot, we accomplished most of our goals.
And just for the record, if you want to go back to college later, you can.
Oh, yeah. And that's something that's down the road, but, you know, when I'm not throwing it
you
out.
You need to chase this dream right now. You're on a roll.
I have the opportunities. And if I stopped right now, it wouldn't be good.
Yeah, that would be crazy. So you sing about love lost and broken hearts. I don't see you being old enough to have that kind of experience. Frankie, do you have that kind of experience that you can actually sing?
I mean, I think everybody does, you know. I mean, to an extent. To an extent, you know. Where a lot of it comes from is I love heartbreak songs.
Okay.
And I love country music.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think
yeah,
a good country heartbreak song, there's nothing better than that to me. I don't know why. I have fun writing them. I have fun resonating with them. And, you know, it doesn't have to be love, in a sense. It could be certain people that have come and gone in your lives.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's how it resonates with me. You know what I mean? Certain relationships you've had. Over the years, you know, it just, you go through changes. And I think that resonates with me and my music, and I love heartbreak songs.
Nice. Speaking of heartbreak songs and you writing, what is it that gets you to sit down and write a song, Frankie?
Oh, boy. If I have the time. That's what everybody says, is like, you make the time to sit down and write. But honestly, writing's been a passion of mine for years. Ever since I started, it's been a passion of mine. And back to what I was saying back playing a few minutes ago, it's the record process. Mm-hmm. Writing is part of the record process.
It is.
And, you know, how close can you make one of your songs to, like, one of the big hits, you know, a Billboard charted hit? How can you craft it and tell a story, yet be commercially viable, yet be this A to Z? I just love, I'm fascinated with sitting down and creating something that will go on to do something and will change somebody's day.
Nice, yeah. Nice. Now, you love the record process. You've talked about that. You talked about it while you were singing.
Yeah.
What do you like more, the record process or performing live?
No, you know, I go back and forth. It depends on what mood I'm in. Honestly, it's weird. Like, you sit there and you just, when you're in the studio, you're like, I think this is my favorite. I think this is my favorite. Then you go out and do a show. You're like, this is definitely my favorite. So I love the whole thing of it. You know, it just depends on what mood you're in. Where you're at and what material you're creating and what audience you have. That makes the difference.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So being on stage isn't like the thing for you. It's the whole process.
It's definitely the thing, but I do love the whole process. You know, it's a business. You know,
nice.
More than a business, it's a business of relationships, and I love making friends. So.
And you do it so well.
Oh, thanks.
You do it so well.
So it's more, you know, that whole thing, you know, doing the whole process. Yeah, I'd say that.
So now that you've charted, you've actually put your name out there where people are going to start to recognize it in a really big way. That's a big deal. So now that you've charted and you're on your way up into the big time, where do you see yourself in 5 years? You'll be 25 years old.
So here's my crazy goals, my crazy dreams, and I'm just going to tell them.
Go ahead.
My five-year goal is to be on a tour, either hopefully opening or headlining major arena tours. You know,
nice.
Being with like Luke Bryan, being with like an Al Dean. Something like that has been a dream of mine my whole life, but now we're starting to get closer and closer to that. It's pretty cool. And not only that, like my dream schedule, I love movie making too. It's another thing, it's kind of like the record process. Like,
yep.
How do you make a movie? How do you make a TV show? It's because I'm an actor as well. So I love to, like, during the weekdays, work in New York or in LA, or LA, or wherever the project is, work on a movie or a TV show. And on the weekends, like Friday through Sunday, go on the road, do that. And that's my dream, is to have both things running really smoothly. Basically, my dream is to not sleep.
I understand that. I'm doing that these days. So
yeah.
I understand. If you could open for anyone in the world, who would you open for?
Oh, man. I've got to open up for some cool guys that I'm like, I'm really happy with that. I really open up with them. But I really want to go on the road. That's this next year or two. I really want to go on the road with some guys.
Like who?
Easton Corbin, would love to go on the road with him again. Lee Bryce, I'd love to go on the road with him again. I've done a show with him this year. That would be really cool. Biggest, best, coolest, you know what would be fun? Dirks and Garth. They would be hilariously fun, because there's people I feel like you're cool around business-wise, and there's people you feel that you're cool you can just hang out with.
Right.
And like when I was hanging out with them, like we just started hanging out. We already felt like
connected.
Friends. You know? Those guys would be fun. Al Dean would be a fun tour.
Right.
And,
have you put a bug in the ear of Garth Brooks that you'd like to go on tour with him?
I've only hung out with him once so far. I got to talk to his people a little bit more about that.
Have his people call my people.
I know his guys, and they're all great guys. You know, the Garth team I met this year, and they've been the guys who've been with him the whole time, and they're really cool people, and I've learned some cool things from them. They've given me some good advice to mm-hmm. go from.
Yep.
I think more than anything, that's really cool, you know, to
right.
see that.
That's great. I'm very proud of you. It's
Thank you.
One of the things that amazes me is that through the last 9 years, give or take, since you were like...
Yep, 11 years old.
You're a little kid. You're the first time you came on my show, you were a little kid.
I know.
And you've grown, but you've maintained that friendly, loving, interactive humility that I think a good star needs. And I have met a lot of people, a lot of stars, and I've worked with some of the best, and a couple of not so humble people. And it's the not so humble people that you really don't ever want to work with again. People are going to want to work with you.
I know.
People are going to want to work with you because you are
humble and
you're gracious.
Thank you.
We love that about you. And I thank you so much for remembering your humble beginnings back here at Grandma's Attic.
Of course, of course.
And I hope that you'll come back when you make a number one hit. When you chart at number one, I hope you'll find a spot. You notice I said when you do.
I like it.
Because you will. When you chart at number one, I want you to come back and share your experience and strength and love with us.
Of course.
Thank you so much for all that you do. Will you take us out with a song?
Of course I will.
Absolutely.
Don't forget to end. This is fun.
It is fun. It's always fun having you in the house. So while Frankie's getting unhooked and guitared up, let me remind you that we are in the winter months. If you have neighbors that have children, please make sure those kids have socks on their feet and mittens on their hands. Please make sure that your elderly neighbors have heat and food in their cupboards. Please check on your neighbors. Our community needs each other. We need to take care of each other. So please do that. Until next week, everybody, thank you so much. I'm so glad we got to bring this interview to you today. Until next week, everybody, bye-bye and have a great week.
Well, this is a song I wrote with a buddy of mine back in Nashville, and it was so cool because he wrote it, and guys, one of my first songs I really went and produced myself. Well, actually co-produced with Larry Rogers, and really took the helm of, and song's called I Love You That Much, still unreleased, but hey, we got it there, and it'll be out here probably next year. Sunrise lighting up the kitchen. Can't talk, coffee hasn't kicked in. She's wearing yesterday's foundation, but she pulls it off amazing. I put a little more sugar in her mug. In her eyes, I see something's up. She asks, how much do you love me? Reply simply, living like Birmingham and Roll Tide. East Tennessee and whiskey nights, like Seminole needs the sun. I love you that much, like Johnny Cash singing Rain of Fire, Sunday revivals and a choir. Like Tim, you gotta have faith, cuz I love you that much. Oh, girl, I love you that much. She said, I always kinda knew, but when you fall so soon, you can't help but question, would you trade it for a second? Girl, I love you like Birmingham and Roll Tide, East Tennessee and whiskey nights, like Seminoles need the sun. I love you that much, like Johnny Cash singing Rain of Fire, Sunday revivals and a choir. Like Tim, you gotta have faith, cuz I love you that much. Girl, I love you that much. Girl, I love you that much. And if you're wondering, I couldn't picture a morning without you smiling. I love you like Birmingham and Roll Tide, East Tennessee and whiskey nights, like Seminole needs the sun. I love you that much, and love you like Birmingham and Roll Tide, East Tennessee and whiskey nights, like Seminole needs the sun. I love you that much. Oh, girl, I love you that much.